So yeah, while cleaning up and getting ready for the scrapyard runs, I managed to find all the LCD monitors that I have accumulated so far, and there's 20 of them. Three or four of them are televisions. This big one, this one, that one, and that one are televisions. They are all broken or all have issues. This one has lines. That one had a cat pee on it because that's from a friend. That one was in the dumpster room and it had a sticker on it saying defective, so I'm not even gonna bother testing it. That one is broken. These are all the old square ones, like the 4x3 ratio that nobody wants anymore. So even if they do work, I'm scrapping them. Some smaller widescreen ones, which are probably not even full HD. Some maybe, but I know this one is. This is one of those swivelly ones that you can actually turn vertical if that, well, take my word for it. It's a Dell one that used to be a good one, but it's all discolored on one side and stuff. Nobody wants this anymore. I can't sell any of these, so gonna scrap them out and just get all the circuit boards and aluminium and steel and get rid of all the plastic. So that's what I'm going to be doing this weekend. And maybe I'll show you what I got out of all of this mess by the end of this. So here's something to be careful with while scrapping out LCD monitors and televisions. They have these small fluorescent tubes in there. Usually the monitors have like one on top and one on the at the bottom. And I actually was unlucky enough to accidentally break one, and it went kind of went bang with a pop, and tiny bits of glass everywhere. Now, the later LED models, they will have a strip of LEDs on the side. So this is a small aluminium strip, I think, that has a stuck on kind of like a circuit board with some LEDs on there. So that's a lot less dangerous. I'm not sure if I'm actually able to get these off of this little aluminium strip. Otherwise, I just throw this in with the circuit boards like that. But these bigger televisions, bigger screens, this is an older Samsung one, has these tubes that go all the way over there, then go in a bend and go back. So these are one, two, three, four, basically fluorescent tubes in there. CCFL, I think they are called. So yeah, be careful with those. I'm not sure how to get these out yet, so I will probably take this to the dumpster room and disassemble it there, basically breaking the crap out of it so that it doesn't shatter all of my apartment here. I'm getting some good progress here. I got most of the stuff scrapped out. I got the bigger TVs still to go, and this thing. I've got a lot of steel. Got some circuit boards. This is aluminium, some cast aluminium even, and a nice pile of circuit boards. Orange bucket there has the wire in it. This is all the small plastic that came out, and I got some bigger plastic bits over there. When this is all done, I'll show you the whole pile and go over some more details. So yes, got the last one done. This is what came out of the last big Samsung TV. First one that actually had an active fan in there. But you got your basic boards, connector boards and all stuff on there. And you get your power board, which has some nice extruded aluminium, which I probably will take off of this one because these are nice and big. I'm not going to go for every individual small one. And then usually there's a couple of these boards where all the screen connections go to. Basically, those go to these strips and they go on the side of the panels. These have sometimes nice gold corner BGAs. There's another one under here, which I will get off. I'm collecting these. I'm going to try to get a significant pile of them and then send them over to e-waste Mike so he can pass them along to his refiner, because there's a fairly decent prices over there and I have no one here to sell them to. So yeah, that's for the future. There was quite some aluminium. There was a lot of the screens, and I got all the layers, all the plastic stuff is still in between. I'll get back to those in a minute. Let's see, got nice double wires. There's a hell of a lot of screws. Not all of these came from the monitors, but I think close to like half of what's in this bucket did. This is all the steel plating from all the monitors. And these are all the boards that I got out. There's quite a pile. You get all kinds of different sorts. Of course, the big ones are from the televisions. Some of the smaller ones also have gold corner BGAs on them. The older stuff really doesn't. And the smaller monitors basically have one small board and one small power board, something like this. I think I had even some smaller ones. Stuff that doesn't look that interesting. This is all low grade, but I will get the heat sinks off. And there's usually like a couple of button boards. Sometimes they have like the clicky buttons that you can actually hear. And then you get those other type of tactile switches. And then there's the touch panels on the more recent ones, which basically have nothing on them. And a couple of LED strips on some of the monitors, and then again some of those strip boards. So all kinds of stuff. I'm not really sure how my scrapyard takes it. I do know they have like a low grade and a higher grade, and then they have computer mainboards which are a grade in themselves. I have a couple of boxes of those as well. So there were also some tiny scrap, micro scrappy bits. These things usually are brass. Let's see, I have a magnet here. I super glued a couple of neodymium magnets in the handle so that I could hang it off the side of either my PC or whatever. So yeah, these are not magnetic, and sometimes these are. So if they're really that strongly magnetic and they stick back on, then they're obviously steel. But these ones usually are vaguely magnetic. There is some reaction there, but that's usually due to either the nickel or chromium, whatever coating that's on there. So this is all brass. These things you find in just about every appliance, and I tend to take them. They add up pretty quick if you get a lot of them. Same deal, if they're not magnetic, they're usually brass. Sometimes they're copper. There was a DVD player in one of the smaller monitors, which was actually a television, small television, which I didn't notice. So I took the little motors out, which will go with copper bearing motors. A whole bunch of those ferrite rings and cores and whatnot. They will probably just end up in the shred pile. But I did hear that these ones that you can open and close might even sell to people who want them, like for, no, a buck a pop. So yeah, and then there was some yellow brass. Usually it's all these like risers or where the holes that the screws fit into. I was able to break out a couple of them. Doesn't add up too much, but I like messing around with stuff like that. There's a little word pun in there because the word messing is Dutch for brass, but whatever. A couple of these things. These are on many of them, the standard connectors. These have brass pins in them, and the solder is usually on there, which I try to collect. And then there's this connector that had a filter in there, so some nice copper in there, didn't expect that. And a couple of these switches, and there was this one. This is, they call this the Mickey Mouse connector. I wonder why. And that actually came with a complete cable, which I will be keeping. The same monitor also had one of these DVI to HDMI converters. Always handy to have at least a few of them. So I'm going to keep those. Again, if you need a power cable that looks like this, Google Mickey Mouse power cable and you'll find this. And then there was some of this copper-like tape and thin sheet copper. Not so much of it, but copper is copper. And there was quite a bit of this aluminium-like tape. You can kind of tell the difference if it's like plasticky or metal-like. So I got the metal stuff all bundled up. Just tossed that in with my aluminium foils for melting. And found an extractable IC chip, which I will just put in with my ICs. So yeah. So there's a whole pile of stuff. I put all the speakers that came out of the televisions and some out of the smaller monitors in here. Those will go in with the shred. This plastic bin has all the smaller plastic bits in it and some of the plastic sheets that were in there. Like I said, the steel was all from the monitors. Most of the aluminium came from the monitors. The Dell screen, this came from a television, by the way. The Dell screen had the most interesting stuff, all the cast aluminium in it. Monitor-wise, that was the most interesting one. Let's see here, because I stacked most of it up here in the hallway. This is all the plastic that came from the TVs on this side here, and I got all the tube lights there, the fluorescent tubes, which I will carefully take to the dumpster. There's all glass, none of them have broken yet. This pile here is all the plastic from all the monitors and some of the stands from the TVs, and this here is all the steel from the TVs. And the steel from the stands is really heavy. So yeah, I'm going to see if I can get rid of most, if not all, of the plastic. The steel I will stack up and get ready for a scrapyard run. And then I'll go and get something to eat, because I think it's close to 6 p.m. now, so close to dinner time. After that, I'll get back to you about this bit. See you later. So yeah, back to these things. I've separated all the panels themselves and all the silvery sheets, all the plastic or plexiglass plates, and I took the white backings off because I don't think there's much use for those. But these might be interesting to use to make something, and the same for these sheets. One of these was a very thin sheet of aluminium, by the way, so that will go in with my sheet aluminium. So if you have any ideas what I could use all these panels for, let me know. These will go to the scrapyard if they are interested, because I know that there's like indium or rhodium or something that you can get out of these, but yeah, you need like a laboratory for that, which I do not have and I don't plan to start. So I'll ask at the scrapyard to see if they want them. If they don't, then they go into the trash. So here's the big ones from the televisions. Unfortunately, all but one have a very rough texture, like a ribbed texture. This one is nice and smooth. I have a plan for that. Let me show you what I'm gonna do with that one. So here's the plan for this plate, plexiglass plate from a 40-inch television. Because I collected quite an amount of stickers and I placed them on my little ingot shelf over here, you might actually notice, if you've kept up, that some stuff is missing. I have a pile of brass ingots weighing down some 3D prints that got all bent. Plant-based resin seemed like a good idea, but it's very bendy. So I got some new Soriatech resin for future prints. But that aside, I have some stuck on there, so I'm going to carefully take those off. I just noticed that Rafael Scrapper's one actually discolored a bit, but those are just made with a printer. So thankfully, he sent me some more, and so did quite a few other people. Here's all the stuff that got sent to me over, well, the 3 years that I've been on YouTube now. My 3 year anniversary on YouTube was actually on October 10th, and my birthday is coming up on October 27th, so yeah. Big party. But all these people have sent me their stickers. I've not made videos about each and every one of them. I did when I got a cool gift like this one from Steve, this bottle opener throwing axe. I think that was my latest mail call video. And yeah, some people sent me some cool stuff. Big Red Bullion, Big Country Scrapper back then, or Redneck, what was it? Redneck Scrapper. He sent me this silver Stormbreaker axe, and I made for him a copper hammer and sent that to him. So let me quickly go over a few of these people. Captain Jerk is also on there. Scrapping Iris has a whole collection of stickers. E-Waste Mike has a normal one and a nice and shiny holographic one. Cruiser Mac even had an envelope with his logo on there and three different stickers. Mo Homesteading. The very first sticker I got was Snobby Scrappicker, his first version of his sticker. Come on, focus. There we go. And this is the newer one, Retro Restore. You got Grass Cutter, Tim Palmer, James Gibson. Crazy Ann has a couple of funny ones. Inmate Grandpa Kevin. This was a running joke about people on panel wearing orange being inmates. And he ran with it, I think, yes. It's kind of a running joke. And Tinkering Taylor. Nev Shack. Parknest spared no expense on the design of his sticker, so I actually have a nice octagon steel shape which I could use as a mold and maybe recreate this out of aluminium at some point. So I might do that. I mean, I get ideas all the time. Let's see, my Dutch friend Metal Scrapper, he's actually doing pretty well. His channel is growing quite consistently. He's also very consistent with his uploads, like every week a new video. Kind of the opposite of me, because I think my last video was like 3 months ago, something. Anywho, Braveheart Scrapper, the old one and the new one, and Ally Mac Mechanical, old one and the new one. Hard Life Survivor, that's a guy who used to hang out with on panels. Haven't seen him around a lot anymore, but very cool stickers. Everyday Solars has the biggest sticker so far, surface area-wise. Here's something cool, Lady Bullion. I did do a video on receiving the channel round. This is the 2020 version. I'm trying to get the 2021 version, hopefully before they run out. And I won some of these copper bars on their channel. These are all the dollar bill bars. I thought those were pretty cool. So the $1, $2, $5, and $100. And now I feel like starting a collection for these. And with every win, they sent me some stickers. So I got those as well. Also, I've promised Lady Bullion that I'd make her some copper sloths, because she really likes sloths. And I have a couple of silicone molds, which I used to make some pewter versions. Now I'm going to make molds of the pewter versions and then sand cast copper sloths, hopefully. At least that's the plan, like I said, get ideas all the time. And I will send them over to her, hopefully within the next year somewhere. Rafael Scrapper, see, this is kind of a difference in color. These used to be exactly the same. And it got worn down by the sunlight, I guess. Snobby and Dusty also sent me some mugs at some point. So I get quite a lot of stuff. Oh, and this is a, should mention this. This is because I became a Patreon at Odin Makes and even got me a very cool enamel pin. He also listed the website or the company that made these. Now, this looks very cool. So I was thinking if I ever go into more merchandise, then I might be able to have a pin made as well. Odin Makes has basically nothing to do with scrapping or the metal casting that I do, but it's a very creative channel and community that I've joined there. He makes props from movies and video games and TV shows, mostly out of foam and plastic stuff for cosplay and cons and stuff. Very cool. I suggest you check him out, Odin Makes. It's actually his real name, Odin, so it's pretty cool. So yeah, what have I done for all these people that have sent me their stickers and their stuff? Basically nothing. So yeah, I've promised to send out stickers because I've gotten some stickers. Let me show you. So first, Rafael Scrapper was nice enough to help me out. I decided to use my channel banner as a template for a sticker. So Rafael printed out a couple of sizes and As you can tell, these are just printed out. Quality is okay, but then again, there's some slight discoloration in there. And I kind of had to get used to the idea of having this sticker like this. But then I went to an official sticker creator, and I found one that does it on... can I have this reflect a bit? Brushed aluminium in the background. So everything that's white on the sticker, so these letters here and maybe a tiny bit in there, ended up being aluminium in the background, which is cool because that's the stuff that I work with. Now, I thought let's give that a bit of an update. So I the lines on top and on the bottom and the letters in there, I turned all white and I put some more emphasis on the little sparkle there. So now that it's even shinier and even better. It was a slightly bit bigger. And I have of version 1, which doesn't have the shiny letters. I have 50 of them. And version 2, I have 100 of them. So I will send out the first one and the second one until the first ones are gone. And after that, I will only send out the newer ones. The cool thing though about the first version is slightly smaller. Check this out. If you have a desktop PC, the smaller one actually fits on a drive bay. It needs a tiny bit of trimming, maybe like half a millimeter on each side, but it will fit one of these drive bay plates. So that's pretty cool. That's where I stuck my first one. So if you use a desktop PC, you can put it on there, if you like. So yeah, this video has been rambling on quite a bit now. So to everyone who would like one of my stickers, or would like to send me one of theirs, or just do a sticker trade, my email is on my about page. You do have to check it out on either a laptop or a PC, because I have gathered that on mobile devices like a phone or a tablet, if you check the YouTube app, the about page doesn't have all the info on it. Now another thing, because I had my 3-year anniversary and my birthday is coming up, people kept hassling me, go live, go live, go collect on all the super chats. Well, that's not really something that I want to do. But if you are feeling generous towards my channel, because everything that I receive goes back into the channel, there is also a... This is the first time and probably the last time that I'm going to be mentioning it. I do have a PayPal link on my about page and a Amazon wishlist. So if you are feeling generous, there's all kinds of stuff on my Amazon wishlist that is just for the channel, like tools and supplies, printer resin, sandpaper, Dremel bits, stuff like that. Go nuts, surprise me if you like, don't feel obligated at all. I have a full-time job. I don't have this channel to make money off of it. Although, you know, sending around appreciation in the form of either stickers or other stuff, or buying me stuff off my wish list is greatly appreciated. I'm going to stick all these stickers on the board and see how far I get. I'm going to carefully take those off using a heat gun and see if that doesn't damage them and they stick on nicely. So yeah, thank you for watching. This was a bit more of a show and tell and mail call video than it was an actual scrapping video. I'm really glad I got rid of those 21 screens. There was actually 21 of them. I'm going to get ready for a next scrapyard run. So see you later for that one. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sending me all this stuff, people. And yeah. Check out the links on my about page. And I will be sending out my stickers very soon. I got a stack of envelopes. These are cardboard backed, so hopefully no bendy. Again, thank you for watching. and see you on the next one.